so we'll get started. On behalf of Farmers Airship, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Zach, and I'm just going to be your briefer boarder today. Your flight attendant is Ginny, and your captain will be Jim Dexter.
All right.
So you have lots of people, lots of resources. If you have any questions up there or any time down here, just go ahead and throw them at us. I'm going to run through the safety stuff. It's a little boring, but you all have a safety card located in your seat back pocket. If you'd like, take a moment to review it, but don't spend too much time, otherwise you'll waste your tour. But it says how to fasten your seatbelt, so it's very complicated. But in order to do so, you insert the metal fitting into the buckle, pull the loose end of the strap to tighten down. To release, just lift the buckle flap. Any questions?
Yeah, it's like the airline.
Yeah.
Just like
There are two doors on the gondola of the airship, and you can see them marked in red here. This is the aft left of the gondola and the forward right. So we're going to use the aft left for boarding and deboarding. So this is the door that we'll primarily use. There are life vests located under each of your seats. Haven't used them yet, but they are there if we need them. Hopefully we won't have to go in that nasty Delaware River water, though. If crew member directs you to it, just pull your life vest out, tear open the plastic packaging that it's in, open it up until you can read top, no front and back, so as long as you can read top. Place it over your head, wrap the strap around your waist, and buckle in front of you. Ooh, last person was thin. And then pull the loose end of the strap to tighten down around your waist. Only inflate the vest after you exit the gondola, and when a crew member directs you to do so by pulling these red tabs, and you have additional flotation by blowing into these oil inflation tubes. Yes, exactly. All right. There, operation of those doors, if you did need to egress the gondola, you can see here, it's basically just a handle that you pull slightly out and rotate down in the direction of the arrow, and the door is spring assisted, so it'll spring open on its own. Because of that, it is easy to open the door. We ask that you don't open the door while we're in flight. You don't mind. For your safety and others' safety. So look after each other too. The windows open up on the doors as well, so you can get some clear photos and fresh air. You know, obviously it's a little hot today, but the breeze at least passes through the cabin makes it nice. So now moving on to something a little bit more specific is our boarding procedures. Let's see how much time we got real quick. So it's a little unique, and this is where you should pay attention, basically. What we're gonna do is drive everybody out into the field in our van, have everybody unload out of the van and get into a close group and then rows of two. And that's because we're gonna board you two person at a time. And we'll do two person on and then have two passengers from the last trip get off of the airship. And that's in order to maintain the weight, the ballast of the ship. So we'll go through that entire exchange, two for two, until we replenish the entire passenger load. And once you are getting onto the stairs, just be careful of that first step onto the stairs because the stairs are attached to the ship. So it does move around left or right as the wind changes direction. And so you just want to make sure you judge that step correctly. Use the handrails. Once you're on, you can have a seat anywhere, fasten your seatbelt. And the flight attendant will direct you further, basically. When you come back, you are the last flight of the evening, I believe. Sometimes they do one more. So they're going to go to the mast truck and basically winch the nose line into the mast. So it's just a cool operation. The flight attendant will guide you through it. But just, you know, be patient and observe and enjoy the experience because it's pretty cool itself. Anytime you're walking to or from the ship, we ask that you don't take any pictures then. But if you're in these groups out front, you can take pictures there. Is there any questions about the boarding process? No, pretty straightforward, right?
I'm going to do it in a happy place. There's always someone here, even in the middle of the night. And my goodness, I tell you, that person has my blessing because I could not stay up that late. But they are always with the ship at all times because no matter what, if a wind starts to come, they need to be able to hold us on here and help, you know, adjust it from, you know, going too high or slamming back down onto the ground. So they adjust the weight and balances of everything. So we do have our passenger van here now, so if you guys want to make sure you have all of your belongings with you, I'll be starting to get you off. You want to stand up?
You're on.